Hello everyone, we will start chapter 8, that is study of compounds, hydrogen chloride. So introduction, its molecular formula is HCl, hydrogen chloride, Cl. Its molecular mass is 36.5. How will you get 36.5? Hydrogen is 1 plus chlorine is 35.5, it will become 36.5. What kind of bond is between hydrogen and chlorine? Covalent. Why covalent? Because hydrogen and chlorine both are non-metal. This dot structure and orbital structure you have done in chapter 2. So do it by yourself. Next one is occurrence. So Lavoisier named it muriatic acid. And next Davy in 1810 named it as hydrochloric acid. So hydrogen chloride gas occurs in free state in volcanic emissions. It also present hydrochloric acid. It is the acid present in gastric juice of mammals. The percentage is 0.2 to 0.4% and it helps in digestion. Next is preparation of hydrogen chloride gas. First method is direct method. In direct method, two or more reactants are there and only one product is there. So see this one, hydrogen gas, chlorine gas. And hydrogen chloride gas is formed. Condition is diffuse sunlight. In the absence of sunlight, this reaction does not occur. And it can also occur in the absence of sunlight, but the condition is that there should be presence of catalyst. And the catalyst is activated carbon. Next one is by heating metallic chloride with concentrated sulfuric acid. So these are metallic chloride, and this reaction we will learn later, leave it. Next, laboratory preparation of hydrogen chloride gas. This is the setup of laboratory preparation of hydrogen chloride gas. This is round bottom flask, thistle funnel, wolf bottle and gas jar. See, sodium, this reaction, sodium chloride, sulfuric acid, it gives sodium hydrogen sulfate and HCl gas, hydrogen chloride gas. No, two reactants are required, sodium chloride and sulfuric acid concentrated. So sodium chloride is taken in the round bottom flask and sulfuric acid is added through the thistle funnel. Then they both will come in contact. In the cold, this reaction is slow. When we heat it, then reaction will be fast. So when the reaction will start, two products will be there, sodium hydrogen sulfate and hydrogen chloride gas when the temperature is below 200. So hydrogen chloride gas, it will form and will come through this delivery tube into Wolf bottle. In Wolf bottle, concentrated sulfuric acid is kept. So this will pass through sulfuric acid. The function of concentrated sulfuric acid to dry HCl gas. Then dried HCl gas will pass through this delivery tube and will be collected in the gas jar. Next one is when the temperature is above 200, then instead of sodium hydrogen sulfate, sodium sulfate will form. Next one is sodium chloride is, why sodium chloride? Only metal chloride is required, only sodium chloride is preferred because it is cheap. Next one is instead of sulfuric acid, this sulfuric acid, nitric acid is not used. Why? Because it is a very important question. Because it is volatile in nature. It can form vapors. It can change into vapor form. So it is not used. Next is purification of HCl gas. Means how can we purify hydrogen chloride gas? It is dried by passing through concentrated sulfuric acid. Other drying agents such as phosphorus pentoxide or calcium oxide is not used as HCl reacts with these. So it is not used. Next one is collection, very important. It is collected by downward delivery or you can say upward displacement of air because it is heavier than air. And how much time it is heavier? 1.28 times heavier than air. It is not collected over water, hydrogen chloride gas, because it is highly soluble in water. Next is identification. How can you check the presence of HCl gas? It is identified by using ammonium hydroxide solution. Also, when you dip a glass rod of ammonium hydroxide solution and brought near to the HCl gas jar, then it will give you it will give you white, dense white fumes. Next one is, it also gives dense white fumes when exposed to air. This is the second identification. Next one is precaution. Precaution is that this thistle ant must be dipped in the sulfuric acid so that HCl gas cannot escape through thistle funnel. And this delivery ant should be dipped in the concentrated sulfuric acid so that it directly, the HCl gas should not directly pass from this side to this side. And another thing, temperature should be maintained around 200. Or below 200, because when the temperature is above 200, then glass apparatus may crack, fuel is wasted, and if the temperature is above 200, sodium sulfate is formed. See this one, sodium sulfate in this above 200, sodium sulfate is formed, which may stick to the glass apparatus and it is difficult to remove. Next one is experiment to demonstrate density. Means HCl gas heavier than air. This experiment shows that when HCl gas is pour on a burning candle, then what happens, this will come down and the air will escape through the jar. So this candle will extinguish. So this experiment shows that HCl is heavier than air. Next experiment, a fountain experiment. This is demonstrated and this experiment shows that the solubility, highly soluble nature of HCl gas. See this arrangement, inverted round bottom flask, and here a rubber cork is fitted. This one is glass apparatus, glass dropper, and this one is jet tube. And here in the trough, blue litmus solution is kept. Now what happens, when we press this dropper, water will go inside, and inside the pressure will become less and outside the pressure will be high. So this solution, blue litmus solution, will enter to jet tube into the round bottom flask. As you know that liquids always flow from high pressure to low pressure, and it will turn, this blue litmus solution will change into red fountain. Why red fountain? Due to the acidic nature of HCl gas. It is acidic in nature. So blue litmus will change into red litmus. Next one is chemical properties of hydrogen chloride gas. Combustibility, neither combustible nor spotter of combustion. Next one, thermal dissociation. It dissociates if the temperature is above 500 degrees Celsius into hydrogen gas and chlorine gas. And it reacts with metal. Hydrogen chloride gas reacts with metals which are above hydrogen in the metal activity series. So these metals can displace hydrogen from the acid and hydrogen gas is given out and respective metallic chloride. Next one is reaction with ammonia. Ammonia gas, hydrogen chloride gas, combination reaction, and ammonium chloride is formed. This question is very important. Name two gases combined to form a solid. So answer is ammonia gas and hydrogen chloride gas. Next one is hydrochloric acid. When hydrogen chloride gas is dissolved in water, then hydrochloric acid is formed. See, HCl when dissolved in water, hydronium ion and chloride ion. Important note is there, dry hydrogen chloride gas and liquefied hydrogen chloride do not turn blue litmus paper red. Because these are non-acidic character, because they do not contain ions. So similarly here, liquefied hydrogen chloride does not conduct electricity due to the absence of ions. This dry hydrogen chloride gas contains only molecules. Next one is laboratory method of preparation of hydrochloric acid. Important one. By which method you can prepare hydrochloric acid? Name of the method is inverted funnel arrangement. See, in this trough water is kept. This one is inverted funnel arrangement. Inverted funnel, there is a source of HCl gas. When HCl gas is passed through this delivery to inverted funnel, Due to the high solubility nature of HCl, this water will dissolve in the gas and it will go up in the funnel, and there will be a gap between water and funnel. And when the pressure inside the gas again become more, and the point will come when the pressure of this gas and outside pressure is equal, then again this water will come downward. This, when the water will go up, this is called back suction. Next one is how the funnel arrangement prevent back suction, because it provides large surface area. If the narrow tube is used, then there will be the chances of more back suction. Next, which precaution is taken? The precaution is attach empty flask, that is called antisuction flask. See this diagram. This is the setup of HCl gas, and here there is a formation of acid, and this one is empty flask, that is antisuction flask is attached between the setup of gas and preparation of acid. So this can stop the chances of explosion. Next one is chemical properties. Nature aqueous solution is strongly acidic and shows all properties of acid. So read it by yourself. Next one is action on metal, like we have done for the HCl gas, same as it is. Next one is action on oxide and hydroxide, action of HCl acid. Now we are doing HCl acid. So acid when react with magnesium oxide, this and O together will make water, and Mg and Cl will make magnesium chloride. So metallic oxide or hydroxide plus hydrogen chloride, hydrochloric acid, gives metallic chloride and water. This is general reaction. So similarly, these reaction are there. Next one is with the salts of weaker acid. These are the salts of weaker acids. And next one is hydrochloric acid. See that when there is carbonate, then carbon dioxide is given out along with the water. And what is the next product? Metal chloride. Which metal is there? Sodium and chloride. Remember, carbonate, carbon dioxide, water and metallic chloride. Next one, if bicarbonate is there, similarly, carbon dioxide, water and metallic chloride. Metal is calcium chloride. Due to carbonate, carbon dioxide and then hydrogen plus oxygen together, they will make water. Next one is sulfites or hydrogen sulfide. This is sulfite, sodium sulfite. This is sodium hydrogen sulfide. When they react with hydrochloric acid, dilute hydrochloric acid, then product is metal chloride, water and sulfur dioxide. Remember, when there is sulfide group, then sulfur dioxide, water and metallic chloride. Metal is sodium, so sodium chloride, potassium, potassium chloride. Rest two products are same. Next one is metallic sulfide, sodium sulfide. This ferrous sulfide. So again, metallic chloride and hydrogen sulfide gas. What is the smell of hydrogen sulfide? It is rotten egg smell. So observation can also be asked. Remember, what is observation? Rotten egg smell, smelling gas is given out. So remember, sulfide group is there, then hydrogen sulfide gas and metallic chloride. Which metal? Sodium chloride. Similarly, the second one. Next, this question is very important. How can you distinguish between thiosulfate or sodium thiosulfate or sodium sulfide? Then you can give this reaction. Sodium thiosulfate, when react with hydrochloric acid, it gives yellow colored sulfur, sulfur dioxide, water and sodium chloride. But sodium sulfide with HCl, what it gives? Can it give sulfur, yellow sulfur? No, it gives only sodium sulfide, it gives only sodium chloride, water and sulfur dioxide. There is no sulfur. Next one is precipitation reaction. In the precipitation reaction, precipitates are formed with HCl, and nitrate groups are there. Dilute HCl does not normally react with nitrate. However, lead nitrate and mercuric 1 nitrate react with hydrochloric acid to give white precipitate. So
silver nitrate can react with hydrochloric acid and gives thick curdy white precipitates. This is silver chloride white precipitates are there, and these precipitates are insoluble in nitric acid. Next one is silver nitrate is used to test hydrochloric acid because it gives curdy white precipitate with hydrochloric acid. Next is oxidation of hydrochloric acid. Oxidation, concentrated hydrochloric acid can be oxidized by using oxidizing agents such as manganese dioxide and red lead. These are the oxidizing agent. They can oxidize hydrochloric acid by removing its hydrogen. So you can see hydrochloric acid concentrated, it is now changed into chlorine by removing hydrogen. And rest two products are manganese chloride, metallic chloride, manganese chloride and water. Similarly, lead dioxide when reacts with hydrochloric acid and in the presence of heat, it will give lead chloride, water and chlorine. So hydrochloric acid is oxidized by using lead dioxide into chlorine. Next one is formation of aqua regia. What is aqua regia? This question is important. So aqua regia is the mixture of three parts of hydrochloric concentrated hydrochloric acid and one part of concentrated nitric acid. It gives nascent chlorine, nitrosyl chloride and water. So the nascent chlorine reacts with noble metals like gold and platinum, and it gives its soluble chloride. Actually, aqua regia, the use of aqua regia is to purify noble metals such as gold, platinum. And when it dissolves, when nascent chloride, it reacts with gold and platinum, it gives their chloride, respective chlorides. And next one is uses, you can read by yourself. Next one is test for hydrogen chloride and hydrochloric acid. If chemical tests are asked, then give this second, third and fourth. These are the chemical tests which we have done before, like how can you test hydrochloric acid when silver nitrate is added to hydrochloric acid. It gives, if you see white color precipitate, then it is hydrochloric acid. Similarly, the question can also be asked in another way. What do you observe when manganese dioxide reacts with hydrochloric acid? So what do you observe? A gas is evolved having color greenish yellow. The chlorine gas is having a greenish yellow color. Thank you. With this we have completed our chapter.